Good day, sir. I am Leslan de la Pasión from BSN 22 Group 2. So for today's video, I will going to demonstrate the physical examination for thorax and lungs. So for the procedure, explain to the client the process and then secure the verbal consent. And then explain to the client what you are going to do and why it is necessary and how the client can cooperate. So, good days, ma'am. I am Leslie Ann de la Pasión, your nurse for today from Tarlac State University. And so, for today, ma'am, I will going to assess your physical examination for thorax and lungs. And I will going to touch your various area of your body. Is it okay for you, ma'am? Okay po, thank you po. And then provide for client's privacy and dignity by closing the door and drawing the curtains. And then for the subjective data, current health status, the cyanosis, cough, and then the chest pain. And then the past health status, the lung disease, exposure, allergies, medications, and use of the oxygen and vaccination. And next is inspect of the anterior thorax. So position the client. The client should be in a sitting position with clothing removed, and except for the examination gown and the drape the properly the client. And then instruct the client to breathe normally. So okay, ma'am, hinga lang po tayo ng malalim. Ayan, very good. And then next is observe with the color. For the lips and nail bed. So, for the normal findings, it is pink undertones indicate the normal oxygenation. And the skin color should be consistent with that of the rest of the body. So for the nail bed, it is normal, and for the lips, it is also normal. So next is inspect the structures of the thorax and then slope of the ribs and symmetry. The clavicle of the client should be at the same height, and the sternum should be in a midline. So it is normal for my patient. The clavicle is in the same position, and the sternum is in the midline of the body. And then next is the structures of the client and chest movement should be symmetrical. And then observe the muscles of the chest and neck, including the abnormal retractions and the use of the accessory, the sternocleidomastoid. So for the for my patient, it is normal. Next is inspect the chest configuration and shape. The adult transverse is diameter is approximately twice that the anteroposterior diameter. And for the abnormal, the barrel chest, carinatum, excavate tomb and kyphosis, scoliosis, and lordosis. Next is count the respiratory rate and then observe the depth and the rhythm. So count the number of the respiratory cycles per minute, and then the normal breath per minute is 12 to 20, and then do not tell the client that you are counting the respiration because it may alter the normal breathing pattern. And then respirations should be even and smooth. And then males tend to breathe abnormally or diaphragmatically. And then for the female, breathe more costally or thoracically. And then for the abnormal findings, it is tachypnea, bradypnea, apnea, hyper, and others. And then next is palpation of the anterior thorax. So palpate the area for the tenderness, lesions, masses, or crepitation on the sternum, ribs, and intercostal space. So locate the supra sternal notch, and then palpate downward to the sternal angle or the angle of Lewis, and where the manubrium meets the body of the sternum. And then palpate laterally to the left and right to locate the second rib and the second intercostal space. Continue palpating the sternum to the xiphoid process and to the left and right of the sternum to count the ribs. So for my patient, it is normal for the crepitation of the sternum, ribs, and intercostal space. And then the sternum should feel flat except for the ridge of the sternal angle and should taper to the xiphoid. The ribs should be should feel smooth, and spacing of ribs and intercostal space should be symmetrical. And then lightly palpate the anterior thorax. Use of the finger pads, include the entire thorax by starting at the areas above each clavicle, and then move from side to side to the below of the costal angle and laterally to the mid-axillary line. Next is muscle mass should be firm and underlying tissue smooth. The chest should be free of lesions or masses, and then the area should be tender to palpation. Next is palpation for thoracic expansion. placing my hands on the lower chest, and then ask the client to breathe. Ma'am, breathe po. Inhale. And then exhale. Next is place the palmar surface of your hands along each costal margin with thumb and close to the mid-sternal line. Pinch mid-sternal line using the thumb. And then pinch up some skin between the thumb and ask the client to breathe or deep breathe. Hinga po ng malalim, ma'am. So for my patient, it is normal. It is it has no lesions or masses, and it is easy to palpate. And then next is palpate for the tactile fremitus. Feel for the vibrations on the chest wall while the client speaks. Ma'am, kamusta po kayo? Okay, very good. And then explain that I will be placing my hands on various area of the chest while the client repeats 99 or 1, 2, 3, and then in a clear and loud voice. So, ma'am, I will going to touch the various area of your body. It is okay for you, ma'am. Okay, very good. And then, pwede nyo po bang sabihin yung 99? Yes. And 1, 2, 3. Okay, very good. Next is the percussion of the anterior thorax. So, penetrates approximately 5 to 7 centimeter. And then, to assess of underlying structures, the usual sound is resonance. And then, begin at the apices of the lungs, and then ask the client to turn the head to the opposite side of percussion to increase the size of the surface required for placing the fingers and to avoid the interference from the clavicle. So, ma'am, tingin po muna tayo doon. And then, percuss the apices of the lungs. And then, next is move to the chest wall and place the finger in the intercostal space parallel to the ribs during the percussion. Percuss the anterior chest from side to side, comparing the sounds. And then next. For my patient, it is normal and it is same sound for the both side of the lungs. And then percussion over the bones or the organs will yield flat or dull sound. Avoid percussion over the clavicle, clavicle, sternum, and the ribs. So next is percussion over the heart will produce dullness to the left of the sternum from the third to fifth intercostal spaces, and then percuss the left lung lateral to the midclavicular line. So avoid percuss the clavicle, the ribs, and the sternum. So, and then next is percussion sound in the lower thorax or lower left thorax. Change from resonance to symphony over the gastric air bone, air bubble, and then percussion sound in the right lower thorax change, and from resonance to dullness at the upper liver border. So for the auscultation of the anterior thorax, ask the client to breathe deeply through the mouth each time the stethoscope is placed on the chest, and to let you know if the client is becoming short of breath or tired. And then place the stethoscope over the trachea above the super sternal to hear the bronchial breath sound. And then move the stethoscope to the left and then the right side of the trachea. It is above the sternocleidomastoid joint. And then place the stethoscope in the apices, the triangular areas superior to each clavicle to hear the vesicular sounds. And then auscultate the bronchial at the second and third intercostal spaces, at the left and right sternal border to hear the bronchovesicular sound. And then move the stethoscope from side to side as I compare the sounds. So move down into the sixth intercostal space and laterally to the mid axillary line to hear the vesicular sound. And then for the assessment of the voice, the client will remain in the same position for the auscultation and percussion. And then explain that I will be listening to the chest while the client says certain words, letters, or numbers. So, ma'am, pwede po ba kayong magsabi ng mga letters, words, or So, for the auscultation of voice sounds, use the same pattern for the evaluating voice sounds as for auscultation of the lungs. So, for the bronchophony, ask the client to say 99 each time I place the stethoscope on the chest. In the normal lung tissue, the sound will be muffled. And for the... So, we do the bronchophony. And then, ma'am, can you say 99? Say it again, ma'am. So, for my patient, it is normal. So, next is for the egophony. Ask the client to say E each time I place the stethoscope on the chest. And in the normal lung tissue, if the client say E, I can hear is E and through the stethoscope. Ma'am, say E. Again po. So, for the egophony, it is normal. Next is percussion of the posterior thorax. Visualize the landmarks and then observe the posterior thorax and visualize the horizontal and vertical lines, the level of the diaphragm, and the fissures of the lungs. Percuss the lungs. And then next is explain to the client that you will be taping on the chest in a variety of areas. Percussion allows the assessment of underlying structures and the usual sound in the thorax is resonance along low pitch hollow sound, and then tell the client to breathe normally through this examination. So I will going to percuss the underlying structures of your body, ma'am. And then may I ask for you to breathe deeply and breathe normally. Yes po. Okay po. Yes, very good. So I will going to percuss, ma'am. And then next is ask the client to lean forward and round the shoulders. Can you please lean forward, ma'am? Yes, po. And then this position moves the scapula laterally, permitting more area of the upper vertebral borders, and then widens the intercostal spaces for percussion. And then next is position the client so that the arms are almost fully extended throughout the percussion. Next is percuss the lungs. Place the finger in the intercostal spaces parallel to the ribs during the percussion. and then standing slightly to the side of the client allows the finger to lie more firmly on the chest as I move through the thoracic line or area. So percuss the lungs. And then percuss the apex of the left lung, then the apex of the right lung. Percuss from side to side, comparing the sounds in the intercostal spaces as you percuss the bases of the lungs and laterally to the or to each mid-axillary line. So, mid-axillary line. So, percuss the left lung or the apex of the left lung. And then, percuss the apex of the right lung. So, for my patient, it is normal and for both sides, it is same, it has same sounds. So, next is percuss for the movement of the diaphragmic or diaphragmatic excursion. The assessment requires the use of the skin, marker, and a ruler. So, explain that you will be doing more taping on the chest and at 2 points, you will ask the client to exhale and inhale and then determine the level of diaphragm during the during quiet respiration by placing the finger above the expected level of diaphragmatic dullness or T7 or T8 at the mid scapular line. So, ma'am, can you please inhale po? And then exhale po. Again, ma'am, inhale. Exhale. So, next, percuss in step downward until the dullness replaces resonance on both sides of the chest and then mark those areas. These marks should be at approximately the level of T10. The marks should be parallel. So, we mark the places where the resonance of both sides will have the dullness sound. So, and then ask the client to inhale fully and hold it as I begin to percuss from the level of the diaphragm downward, moving from resonance to dullness. So, ma'am, inhale po, fully inhale po. And then, the distance between the mark should be at 5 centimeter or 11/4 to 2 inches. And even on each side, the right side may be 1 to 2 centimeter higher because of the location of the liver. and anticipate the greater distance on a physical fit client. So, as for my client, it is normal. So, next is for the auscultation of the posterior thorax. Ask the client to drip or to breathe deeply through the mouth each time the stethoscope is placed on a spot, and tell the client to let you know if she is becoming tired or short of breath, and if so you will stop and allow to rest. I will going to auscultate your posterior thorax, ma'am. And pwede nyo pong sabihin sa akin kung kinulang po kayo sa hininga and or pagod po kayo. So, percuss that posterior thorax. Next is visualize the landmark as you did before the percussing posterior thorax, and compare the result. Compare the result should be symmetrical, like pinch intensity, the quality, and the duration. So auscultate for the tracheal sound at the vertebral line superior to C7. And then next is auscultate for bronchial sound. Start at the vertebral line at C7, and then move the stethoscope downward or to the T3. The sound will be bronchial. So, next is auscultate for the vesicular sounds. Auscultate the lungs by following the pattern used for percussion. Move the stethoscope from side to side while comparing the sound. Start at the apices and move to the bases of the lungs and laterally to the mid-axillary line. The breath sounds over most of the posterior surface are vesicular. So, start at the apices of the lungs. And then, move to the base of the lungs. For the for my client, it is normal and both sides are has the same sound. So for the interpretation and documentation of findings, refer to the descriptions and interpretations of normal and adventitious breath sound. So, and the data for documentation, the date and time, the procedure done, and findings. And if with abnormal findings, action taken, referral to physician, and intervention done. And then, next is patient's response to the intervention. So for my patient, it is all normal findings. So that's all for the physical assessment for thorax and lungs. Thank you for watching.